Okay, welcome to this part one of the chapter one from the text, which is on real number. Okay, here what are the real number? You have come across doing the problem regarding the number. What is actually this real number? Most of the time we have come across the number and we didn't know which kind of number they are. We have come across a natural number, even number, odd number, prime number, whole number, fraction, rational number, irrational, all this type of number. But as a whole, all these number, they are consisting under the real number. Okay, all these number that we are this that you have come across right from lower classes till this class, they are the part of the real number system. Okay, the broad division of real number, there are two broad division of real number, which one is rational number and the other is irrational number. Irrational number, they are no such broad class, again broad classification of this irrational number, but this rational number has a wide classification of this rational number. Within rational number we have the integers, within the integers we have the whole number, and within whole number we have the natural number, within natural number we have what? Even number, odd number, prime number. Okay, that means all the natural number, they are the whole number. All the whole number, they are integers. All the integers, they are rational number. All the rational number and irrational number, they are part of the real number. Okay, I think you are clear with this. What are these real number? Now let's go with the divisibility of this real number. A non-zero integer A is said to divide another positive integer B if there exists an integer C such that B equal A multiply C. That means if you take any number and that number is said to divide another number, if that number multiply with another such number, the product of these two should give you that number which we are going to divide. Now suppose I've given you 10 is equal 2 multiply 5. Divisibility of 10, 2 is said to divide 10. Why? Because 2 multiply 5 equal 10, isn't it? Therefore any number can say that it is a number divisible if that number, if there exists another number that the product of these two should give you this number that we are going to divide, then that number non-zero integer A is said to be a number which is divisible. Okay, now as I've given you example that if 10 equal 2 multiply 5, that means 2 is said to be a number divisible to which number? 2 is a number divisible to 10. That means 10 is divisible by which number? By 2. 10 is divisible by 2 because 2 multiply 5 equal 10. Very simple, even though it's very simple, what is divisibility? That if a number multiply with another number give exactly the same value as that number, then that number is said to be divisible by this integer A. Here, what is B? B is the dividend. A is the divisor, and C is the quotient. Dividend is equal divisor multiply quotient. That is the divisibility. Now we come to the Euclid division lemma. Given any two positive integer a and b, then there exists a unique whole number q and r such that a is called bq plus r, where 0 is less than equal to r less than b. This means this Euclid division lemma is saying about if there is a non-zero integer a which is not divisible to another positive integer b, then if it's not divisible, then what remainder should will be there, isn't it? If it is divisible, then there is no remainder. Is exactly divisible, there's no remainder. But if that number is not exactly divisible, then you'll get remainder, which is given by r, and the value of r should be less than equal to 0 and should be greater r should be greater than equal to 0 and r should be less than b. This is the Euclid division lemma. Okay, we'll discuss this in the next slide, in the next page. Here, what is A? A is the dividend, B is the quotient, Q is the divisor, B is the divisor, Q is the quotient, and R is the remainder. Now, suppose this Euclid division lemma. You consider this Euclid division lemma. Now, we take the number 9 divided by 2. If you divide 9 by 2, then the first and foremost thing that right from very lower classes we have been teaching about the division. How they are teaching us, if you divide 9 by 2, then the first thing you should remember, what you should remember, 2 should be multiplied with such a number that the product should be equal to 9 or less than 9. That is the main idea of division. Mean the main logic of this division. This means if 2 is the divisor, 2 should be multiplied with such a number, mean a whole number. It's not that number should be decimal point or a fraction, but 2 should be multiplied to such a non-negative integer q where the product should be equal or less than 9. If 9 is divisible, then 2 multiply that number is 9, but 9 is not divisible by 2, isn't it? 9 is not divisible by 2, then you will get remainder. But how much you should go 2 multiply, how much you should go here? You cannot go 2 multiply 3 equals 6, because you can go by another higher number, which is 4. 2 multiply 4 is 8. It's less than 9. But you cannot go with another bigger number. 2 multiply 5 is 10. You cannot go with 5. You cannot either go with 3 or you cannot go with 5. Because if you go with 3, 2 multiply 3 is 6. But the rule of division says that you should go with that a number which is less or equal to 9. 2 multiply 3 is 6 is very less than 9. Therefore, you should go with a number which is, you try to go with 4. If you go with 4, 2 multiply 4 is 8. Then still, this dividend is bigger. You can subtract 9 minus 8 is 1. But you cannot go with a number which is 2, which is more than this db, then 2 multiply 5 is 10, then on subtracting you'll get minus 1. Okay, this is the actual rule of this Euclid division lemma. Mean if you multiply to that number, the remainder here should be less than equal to 0 or should not be greater than d dv sir. Okay, here if you multiply 2 multiply 4 is 8, you are getting 1. 1 is remainder is less than b. 1 is less than 2, isn't it? You cannot go with 2 multiply 5 become 10. 10 you will get remainder will be minus 1. Remainder should not be negative according to this Euclid division lemma. Therefore, this Euclid division lemma says about the division. You can how you will divide a number with a given divisor. This actually this right from lower classes I've told you we have come across division of a number, but how is going, how the process is going, with by which rule is going, we don't know. But we just told that you have to go, you have to multiply to such number which is less than equal to the dividend. But here in class 10 we are the exact rule is being taught to you, that this rule is because of the Euclid division lemma. It's clear. Now this question is the same thing. You just go through this, but it will be whatever I've discussed you is the same thing. We should go by a number which is less than equal to the dividend. That's why here the remainder should be always lies between 0 and b, should be less than, r should be greater than 0, should be equal or greater than 0, but should not be less, should not be greater than b. R should be less than b, that means r should not be greater than b. R remainder should not be greater than the divisor. Remember that remainder should not be greater than the divisor, and r should not, remainder should not be negative, not less than equal to 0, that means should not be negative. Remainder should not be negative and remainder should not be greater than the divisor. This is the meaning of this condition, that r lies between 0 and b. Now we come next to the Euclid division algorithm. What is Euclid division algorithm? The Euclid division algorithm says about obtaining the SCF of two integers a and b with a is greater than b. Now to obtain the SCF of any two positive integer a and b with a greater than b, these following steps are to be followed. The first step, apply Euclid division lemma to a and b and find the whole number q and r such that a is called bq plus r. That means you are doing division and find out the remainder is how much, where the remainder should always be between 0 and b. Okay, now you do the division, you know how to do the division. You take if a is greater than b, you take a as a dividend, b as the divisor, you divide those two numbers and find out what will be the remainder. Now if remainder is 0, no need to proceed ahead. Just directly you can say that the divisor at this step is the LCF. But if remainder does not equal 0, again you take the remainder to be b, to be the divisor, and the previous divisor to be the dividend. Again apply the step 1, again take remainder as the divisor and the previous divisor you take as the dividend, and then divide again, you find out whether remainder is 0 or not. If it is 0, you can say that the divisor at that step is the LCF. Otherwise, if the remainder is not equal to 0, again you go to the step 1 in which the remainder at that step should be taken as the divisor, and the divisor of the previous step should be taken as the dividend. Okay, you go on continue. If remainder is equal to 0, again you go on continue the process of division till you find remainder is equal to 0. The step at which remainder is equal to 0, then the divisor at that step is the CF of the two number. It's clear? Now, let us see here. CF of 21 and 30. 21 and 30. If you go with 1, it's 21. You cannot go with 2 because it's 42. You have to go to 1 only. 21 mod 1 is 21. Remainder is 9. Remainder is, here remainder does not equal 0. Then what you will do, you will take this 9 as a divisor. The previous divisor you will take as dividend. 21 you take as dividend. Again you divide. 9 multiply 2 is 18. Remainder is 3. Remainder is not 0. Therefore, again you take this 3 to be the divisor, and the previous divisor to be the dividend. 9 you take as the dividend. 3 multiply 3 is 9. Remainder here is 0. Then which is the HCF? The last divisor is the HCF. Okay, 3 is the HCF. Now, using the Euclid division algorithm to find the HCF of 56 and 88. Okay, now the given number are 56 and 58. Since 88 is greater than 56, you take A to be 88, B to be 56. Applying Euclid division algorithm to A and B, that means 88 divided by 56, 56 multiply 1 is 56, remainder is 32. This means applying Euclid division algorithm to A and B, you will get 88. You take this dividend. 88 is equal 56 multiply 1 plus remainder 32. Here remainder does not equal 0. Therefore, what you will do, you will take this A to be the previous divisor and B as the remainder you will take as B. 32 you will take as B. Again, you have A and B. Again, apply the Euclid division algorithm to this new A and B. 56 divided by 32, you'll go with 1, 32, remainder 24. Here remainder is 24. Again, you have to proceed ahead. You take this 32 as A and 24 as B. The remainder you take as the divisor again, and this 32 to be the dividend. Okay, take 32 to be A and B is 24. This A dividend, B is the divisor. Now applying 32 divided by 24, 24 you will go with 1, 24 remainder is 8. Now the process didn't stop here because remainder is not equal 0. Again you take here 8 to be the divisor B and 24 is the as the dividend. Now 24 divided by 8, 8 multiplied 3 is 24, remainder here is 0. What is the last divisor? It is 8, isn't it? 24 is equal to 8 multiplied 3 plus 0. Then this 8, the last divisor at this step will be taken as the HCF, the last divisor. Okay, or if you are doing in shortcut method here, 88 divided by 56, 56, 1, 56, remainder 2. Take this 32 as divisor, take 56 as the dividend, 32, 1, 32, remainder 24. Since remainder is 0, is not equal to 0, again you take 32 as the dividend, 24, 1, 24, remainder 8. Again, remainder does not equal to 0, you again take this 24 as the dividend, 8 multiply 3 is 24, remainder here is 0. The last divisor at this step is 8, therefore the HCF will be 8. Okay. The same can be solved in the following way once we understand the logic of this Euclid division algorithm. Find the LCF of 56 and 88 using Euclid division algorithm. The given number are 56 and 88, which is greater? 88 is greater than 56. Therefore, you take 88 as A, 56 as B. Now 88 will be 56 multiply how much? Multiply 1. Remainder 32. Remainder is there. Then you have to proceed ahead. Then you take this previous divisor as the dividend. This divisor, this step, you take as the dividend. Then this as the 32 as the divisor. 32 multiply how much? Multiply 2 also. If you multiply with 2, it is 64. Therefore, you go with 32 multiply 1 plus remainder 24. Remainder is not 0. What you'll do? You'll take this 32 as the dividend, 24 as the divisor. 32 divided 24, you'll go again with 1. Remainder is 8. Now, since remainder here does not equal 0, again you have to proceed taking this divisor as the dividend, 8 as the divisor. Now, 8 multiply 3 is 24. Remainder is 0. Therefore, this 8, the last, the divisor at this last stage will be taken as the LCF. It's clear? This is the end of the part 1. We shall discuss this again the next class for the part 2. Okay, bye to all of you.